This is Gary Atencio with CNTV, and today we're in Centennial, Colorado. I'm here with Suzanne Wolf, health insurance advocate. Since 2019, she has provided a better level of health coverage for people just like you. Suzanne, let's start off a little bit about yourself. You've been an advisor, an educator, and your story really is a personal journey as a teacher in the classroom for 18 years. Some events unfolded in your life where you wanted to really provide more of an impact. This journey has not been without some very difficult challenges. Now, with some firsthand experience, you were able to provide connection and really hope to some clients. Tell me a little bit about this.
Thank you so much, Gary. I appreciate it. I have really been blessed with a lot of different opportunities in my lifetime, and I have found that in these opportunities, I found some pain, but some wisdom. And when I was teaching second and third grade for almost 18 years, I got to have the opportunity to empower kids, to infuse a joy of learning. Then my mom passed away from cancer. She was my everyday, and it was a very deep grief. I decided I wanted to try and honor her memory more than one classroom at a time. I came up with a nonprofit called Project Peace, promoting empowerment, awareness, community, and empathy. And I just wanted to try and make her proud every day. It was my reason to get out of bed and to have purpose. And so that was the beginning of some adversity, but ended up having some joy. Then my husband was diagnosed with stage 4 colon cancer. So I was taking a leap of faith, trying to make a difference in the world, and didn't have any income. So we ended up having a crisis to deal with on so many levels, just the fear of losing my husband more than anything, trying to navigate the system without the right coverage, and getting upside down in medical debt. And that was all really overwhelming. I had to question what I was trying to do, what my purpose was. Really, we were in survival mode. And so I ended up having to drive for Lyft, even though I was still doing my nonprofit work. Uh-huh. And I realized my husband had an amazing mindset, amazing faith. He's currently in remission, which is amazing. But we ended up finding a way to not lose the house and not lose anything. But as a result, we gained some wisdom about a light to pay forward. To others about how insurance works, how it doesn't, and how to manage when something catastrophic happens and turns your life upside down. So I call that the blessing in my pain, that really these things have to happen so that I would find this opportunity to now help other people to not have this happen to them.
Obviously, anyone who has lived any type of full life knows that life happens. Be it sickness, accidents, disease. I mean, many times these do more than just put your life on pause. Why do you feel that people need to be prepared for the future, even more important maybe today than it was back prior to when you first began?
You know, Gary, I think that's my big challenge right now, is to try and infuse in others this urgency to be protected. You know, I want everybody to be able to live their lives out loud. Nobody is immune from something happening. We're dealing with a pandemic right now. I've had clients that were in their early 20s and perfectly healthy that had something catastrophic happen. You just can't assume. And the problem when you do is that you put yourself in a position of the unthinkable, and we've lived that unthinkable. I don't know that people go there. They just say, why do I bother having coverage? I can't afford it, or it's too expensive, or it doesn't serve me. But they don't realize that by having the right coverage, and not all coverage is the right coverage. That's part of what I do, is empower people to know their options, what serves them, But if they don't know, then they won't know what it's like to live out of a coin jar that was supposed to be our dream vacation jar and that I was using for the quarters to tank up my car to give Lyft rides and to walk down the aisles of King Soopers, wondering if we could afford to buy the $1.99 milk bones that week. And remembering in that aisle saying, let's remember this moment because this is part of what defines us and we're going to be okay. But you don't ever get that sense of this is what it will feel like. This is what it will feel like on the 15th of every month when the mortgage is due and are we going to lose the home, our home? And you don't think about what that looks like. Well, we have actually lived and survived that. And so I just want to present an authentic, you know, way of showing that you don't want to go there. It's anxiety. You know, Gary, I couldn't even walk to the mailbox and touch the envelopes of the bills that we owed because as an educator, I had perfect credit and everything was paid up to the zero balance. So when I had stacks of envelopes, I had such anxiety and my husband would say, sweetie, aren't you going to open those? And I'm like, I can't touch them. We can't pay these and I'm not used to that. So to go from perfect credit to credit card consolidation was all part of the journey. And so people don't know, what does it look like if that happens? Well, I can help them with that. And maybe that makes it more meaningful for them to realize it's important to be covered.
We are now past the year 2020. One thing that year taught us is that it can happen to us. I mean, do you feel people's awareness of their health has risen? And can that be a good thing?
I think there are a lot of things that this pandemic has brought to us that are silver linings. That's kind of the way I've just decided to live my life. I wasn't always great at it, but just to really be able to reframe what is a blessing in this? What is something positive? Well, we started caring about our neighbors more. We started checking in on people. We started to have more regard for how other people were suffering or struggling, and that is a beautiful thing. I think that it is something that is very present now to see loved ones on ventilators or having lost loved ones. It really has become the most concrete thing we could possibly live together. And so it's really difficult to ignore any longer just how grateful we should be to have every day, every moment of every day. And that's something that my husband and I, you never think that cancer can bring blessings, but for us, it's brought a lot of gratitude, a lot of presence to just enjoy every day. Yeah. And I think that's what I like to try and infuse. In addition to just helping empower people with health insurance options, I want to infuse in them just what life, you know, is supposed to be with our gratitude and our regard for each other.
Would you agree that every customer is unique and really a one-size-fits-all approach is not always the best answer? I mean, I would imagine step number one for you is really listening to the needs of your client. Is that something you enjoy, really getting to know them?
That's everything to me, Gary. And to be honest, for me as a licensed advisor, which you can differentiate from a broker or an agent, it's not that one is better than the other, but just to understand that as a licensed health advisor, I am licensed and certified in 31 states, and I'm able to actually analyze with each person what their best option is. It may not even be our plan. As a matter of fact, a lot of times it isn't. That doesn't mean we don't have good plans, but you really have to take into account if somebody has a chronic health condition, if somebody's perfectly healthy, where they need to land are two different places. I personally landed on Medicaid. I couldn't afford the COBRA after my mom passed away of $824 a month. I thought COBRA was the only option. It almost bankrupted me and I ended up in tears at the Medicaid office and said, this is supposed to be for the people I'm helping in my nonprofit. And this very kind woman said, oh no, sweetie, you're exactly what Medicaid's for. Well, it still felt like a very humiliating thing to be on Medicaid, and I'm a capable person. So I had to experience the gamut of Medicaid, COBRA being too expensive. And I didn't have a person myself, Gary, that was able, except for that lovely woman, that was able to help me navigate from there. And so I actually had somebody put my birth year in wrong by one digit. And that caused me to not be able to refill my medications for 3 weeks. And I just called, and I was on hold for 2 hours, and I was like, who can just push the backspace and change the 4 to a 5? And there were all of these different, that is HIPAA, there are all these reasons. And I said, no, HIPAA is supposed to protect me. Where do I need to go for somebody to change one digit? And for 3 weeks, Gary, I couldn't get my prescriptions refilled. I can't begin to tell you how vulnerable and humiliated and just overwhelmed I was that nobody cared about me. And that became a real defining moment for me about, I want to be someone's person. I don't want anybody else to feel that way. So it could be that somebody does need Medicaid, or somebody does need free clinics that speak Spanish. I want to take the time for them because I feel like that's the privilege I have to say, I actually am resourced. I can get you where you need to be. And for me, that is embodying what it's supposed to be, the mission of hope, which is helping other people every day. And that really matters to me. And so this is my passion and purpose now.
Obviously, insurance covers me 24/7. This also covers me at home, but does it also cover me when I'm at work or out and about? When someone is insured and they choose to go with an in-network provider, I mean, obviously that will save them the most amount of money. But would you say most of the plans that you offer, I mean, can I choose any doctor if that's what I decide?
And so, Gary, again, there are plans available where they are wanting you to be able to travel and have a PPO network to kind of differentiate. EPO is the smallest network. It has certain number of doctors, certain hospitals. It's pretty restricted. HMO is your basic managed care, where you have a primary care physician. If you want to see a specialist, you have to get a referral, and there are certain hospitals. Again, PPO is a network that literally gives flexibility. If you want to go to a specialist, you just call and make an appointment. You don't need that primary care to manage your care. You can directly call. So there's greater flexibility with PPO plans. And for some people, when that's an option, I truly celebrate, because, you know, we all should have that equity of resources. And what I try to do is, when people don't qualify for that, I still try to figure out the best scenario. I do a lot of out-of-the-box thinking. You know, the whole idea of a family plan or a group plan, you know, that I think it's, there's a new trend now, Gary, where it really makes more sense to cater to the individual needs of employees, for example, or for family members. You might have somebody that's diabetic in your family and everybody else is healthy. Well, you shouldn't be on a family plan, because you're really going to be spending a lot of money on your healthy people when you shouldn't have to misuse those funds. So I usually split people up into different scenarios that really meet their needs, so that overall, everybody is getting the best care they can have, and they're saving money, because this educator brain of mine is really geared to try and help people manage their finances wisely. With, this is an investment. And I think it's really important that people understand that I take that very seriously to help them with such a huge decision.
As you personally know, not all sicknesses or even diseases can be labeled critical or serious critical. How does a critical care plan really help someone?
Well, Gary, I'd have to say, if we are the poster children of any part of the supplements that are out there, it would be this critical illness supplements. You know, you don't think about, again, what happens when cancer is diagnosed or you've had a stroke or a heart attack, you can't work. The majority of the time, you're going to miss work and you're not going to have a stream of income. And so I get to use my husband as an example of, if my husband had had this coverage before this happened, this is how much we would have been out of pocket, which is very minimal. We also would have had a stream of income, a lump sum check that would have defrayed whatever was going to be out of our pocket. And we would have had money in the bank to pay the mortgage, to buy the groceries and the milk bone dog biscuits, and to not have to drive for Lyft and know that if I need to do 5 rides so I can pay the Excel bill tomorrow. I mean, it literally was down to, I drove for Lyft because they paid out every night, and I was in that kind of place where we didn't have savings. A lot of people, and I'll ask, do you have enough savings for 6 months to keep yourself afloat if something happens? This is a question I ask my clients. And if they can say, we do, we're great, I'm like, fantastic, then you don't need these supplements. But if you don't, then this is something to consider, because you don't need to have additional anxiety of paying the bills and touching the envelopes when you're just worried about round 12 of chemo or what's going on in your world that is terrifying. So these are supplements. They are in existence. They help with accidents. They help with critical illness. And it's just a wise thing to try and make sure you've got a stream of income coming in if you don't have enough savings for 6 months, which is kind of the parameter I use to guide people.
Do you think it's pretty common for people not to want to really think about life-threatening diseases? Yet we realize this happens every day. There are thousands of people that are diagnosed every single day, and most of the time they don't think it's going to happen to them.
That's exactly right. And I think, Gary, that I feel blessed that I have an authentic experience that really can't spell it out any better. And I have had permission from other clients to be able to share what they went through and if they had had this coverage, what would happen. And it's literally about empowering people. And so when I have the opportunity, which I'm grateful you're giving me, just to speak to somebody, it doesn't cost anything, and I feel like I can at least help pay this light forward so others don't have to go through it. And I'm a phone and text away from all of my clients. I'm on their journeys, so I don't just help them with the plan and disappear. I'm their person. It's come full circle that I get to be that person that wasn't there for me. And that's probably the most meaningful part of all, is that my clients text me weekends, holidays, nights, and whenever. And I don't get upset about that, because I'm like, they're vulnerable and I'm their person. So this is a blessing.
Suzanne, you have personally experienced some of these challenges back at a time when you were not covered. I mean, life basically turned upside down for you. Before you were an educator, you're now really an advisor, someone who helps others. Is this rewarding for you and something you still enjoy, really your mission of providing hope as an advocate?
You know, Gary, we think that you can find one job in a lifetime that is your passion and purpose, but I have honestly been blessed, and I have a greater understanding of why everything's happened now. At the time, you're steeped in it, you're like, why is this happening? This is so hard, this is so awful, it's depressing, it's anxiety provoking. But having had space from that now, I sit back and go, well, I see some common strands here. I am still an educator. I'm still empowering people. I am an advocate, which is part of my nonprofit work too. My nonprofit work was really to lift others up and to provide an equity of resources, regardless of zip code. I'm very passionate about that. And so for me, being resourceful with my teacher brain, I actually feel blessed that I am in this position now. It gives me an even greater purpose. And I know that I'm making my mom proud every day. Wow. As well. And that really, when all is said and done, is what I've been striving to do since I left the classroom.
Viewers, take a look at the bottom of the screen. Her contact information is right there. Basically, if there's a specific plan you're looking at, she can walk you through it. We want to really educate people out there on some of the advantages, really, of being prepared so that something like this won't happen to you and you'll find yourself in the same situation. Once again, that is Suzanne Wolf, Health Insurance Advocate. This is Gary Atencia with CNTV. And if you don't know, now you know.